Hey guys, it's Gary. What is a Honda CRX? Is it a Civic? Is it a Del Sol? Or is it a Ballad? What the heck is a Ballad? I'll let you know in this video on the origin of the Honda CRX. The Honda CRX is one of those cult classic old school JDM front wheel drive cars from the mid 80s and early 90s. It's most popular for its wedge-like body style, lightweight, handling, and engine options. I'm only going to focus on the US version of the CRX with reference to a few JDM offerings because things get really confusing outside of here. Let's start the CRX history by going back to Japan in the 1970s. Honda was in its infant stages and still trying to figure out their dealership sales channels. By 1978, they created the Verno network of dealerships. The Verno network sold restyled versions of Honda cars like the Ballad, which was a Civic in disguise. The Ballad Sports CRX was first introduced in June of 1983 for Japan, which was a sporty hatchback coupe and foreshadowed the next generation Ballad or Civic that was released later in September. So technically, the CRX came before the third generation Honda Civic. It was targeted at younger buyers as a fun, economical, and sporty commuter. The CRX wasn't originally planned for import into the US. A few enthusiasts at Honda fortunately convinced them to do so, and we would eventually become its largest market. The CRX acronyms have been widely accepted to mean Civic Renaissance Model X. We only saw the CRX here with no hyphen before the X. Honda's supercar, the NSX, would later use something similar, but stood for New Sports Car Experimental. We received the first generation here as the Civic CRX in 1984. It has a unique wedge-shaped sport coupe body style. This design is described as a camback which reduces drag. It was sold as a two-seater in the US and four-seater for other markets. The rear seats may not be much of a seat, but Honda referred to it as a one-mile seat, and fortunately, it could fold down for additional cargo space, just like the US version. The CRX had a shorter wheelbase and was slightly lower than the Civic, and offered in two trims, a fuel efficient and sport. In 1985, the HF, or high fuel, appeared, and it became the first car in the world to have an estimated 50 miles per gallon, and it wasn't even a hybrid or electric car. In spring of that year, we received the single overhead cam 1.5 liter for the legendary SI or sport injected trim, while the Japanese version, of course, getting the better dual overhead cam ZC engine a year earlier. As for suspension, it had a torsion bar in the front and beam axle and trailer link in the rear. The handling was good compared to American competition, and performance was very similar to the sportier and more expensive Volkswagen Rabbit GTI. A facelift was implemented in 1986 with a few other refinements which caused it to have the best sales year in the US. Competition was also fierce in motorsports such as SCCA and IMSA due to the CRX's racing potential. The second generation CRX received changes in 1988. It remained a two-seater for the US but slightly larger and heavier. The body style became more sleek, and it now had double wishbone at all four corners. The most unique feature to the CRX is the glass panel in the rear, which helped with visibility. The US received the HF, Standard, and SI with the single overhead cam D16. The Japanese version initially received the D16 ZC with the SI, and then in 1989, an SIR came out with the VTEC B16A engine. All hope was not lost for our underpowered CRXs, as the popularity of VTEC engine swaps made it possible for us to have this combination in the US. The dual overhead cam ZC and B16 had different hoods to clear the taller engines, and you can see here the US hood sits lower because we only got the single overhead cam, which didn't need the hood clearance. If you do swap over to a dual overhead cam, you might need one of these hoods or an aftermarket one for clearance. Most have gotten away with just cutting the frame underneath, or you can cut a hole in the hood so everyone can see what you have. This generation is what I think of when someone mentions CRX. What about you? It was sporty, fun to drive, capable of engine swaps, and continued being raced and won several competitions. There was a point when Honda even sponsored a racing series called the CRX Challenge. The third generation CRX is controversial. It came in as the 1992 Honda Civic Del Sol for the US and was supposed to be the successor to the CRX. Del Sol in Spanish translates to of the sun. It was badged as the CRX Del Sol or CRX in other countries, which meant it continued the CRX legacy. Let's just say this is the revised third generation CRX, which shared the same chassis as the EG Civic. The Del Sol was a true two-seater and did away with the traditional wedge hatchback shape of the former CRX. It seemed to be in response to the Mazda Miata though. Since Honda didn't have a rear-wheel drive platform to use, they made the Del Sol look like a roadster with a targa top, and it also had a mid-engine body style. The reality is that it was front-wheel drive and got heavier than the previous generation CRX, which distanced itself away from its roots. The US received two trims, the S and the SI. Engine offerings were initially a 1.5 liter and 1.6 liter single overhead cam, and then the dual overhead cam B16 VTEC engine was introduced in 1994 for the SI. Despite the fifth generation Civic ending production in 1995, there was a facelift in 1996 which eliminated the front auxiliary headlamps. The Del Sol continued on and ended in 1997 for the US and 1998 for the rest of the world. There was no implication of a next generation CRX prior to this model's discontinuation. On a side note, do you guys think the Del Sol might have given inspiration to the S2000? Let me know in the comment section below. The fourth generation was sold in 2010 as the CRZ or Concept Renaissance Zero. This is also debatable as it's supposed to be the modernized spiritual successor to the second generation CRX. It now became a hybrid and rated as one of the least polluting cars. It used a 1.5 liter single overhead cam 4-cylinder with Honda's integrated motor assist hybrid electric system and came with a 6-speed manual or CVT. This car was capable of about 39 miles per gallon with all the hybrid tech it received, which honestly still can't beat the mid-1980s CRX's simple internal combustion engine with no technology and 50 miles per gallon. Suspension was borrowed from the Honda Insight and Fit. The CRZ received a facelift in 2013 with a slight power increase and then another revision in 2016. Purists would agree that it does look like a modern CRX, but would disagree it's a spiritual successor because its characteristics and performance are no longer that of the CRX of the past. It was just marketing at work, and the truth was clear when it became discontinued in 2016. The CRX was one of the early hot hatches and helped Honda progress into the market which has now been taken over by the Honda Civic hatchback. Let me know if you think the Del Sol or the CRZ was the rightful successor to the CRX. Other than that, like if you enjoyed this video and subscribe for future content. I'll see you in the next one.